guys, you need to wear good clothes, good shoes, good jacket. So come here prepared. So don't get worried, you will not get lost. Hello guys, welcome to Banco Chili Peppers TV. I am Moda and today I landed in Bergen and I rented a car to reach Tissendal and climb Toltunga. But before of that, I want to explore the area around Tissendal and Odda because I know there are very beautiful waterfalls. This is a journey of about 3 hours under the rain, but the nature is very beautiful. The best way to explore Norway, I think, is with a car.
The Bergen area is famous to have an average of 230 rain days per year. As mentioned, the best way to explore Norway is via car. The rent is expensive. I found that Six is the cheapest provider and the price for a small middle-sized car is in between 100-150 euro per day. Keep in mind that several routes in Norway require to take a car ferry. The average price is 20 euro per crossing. The payment is very easy, you have to do nothing. Your rental car will have a toll tag.
So, just arrived in Tissedal. When you work for a TV channel, you get very nice room. That's all for me.
Just few minutes to leave my bags and then out again to explore the beauties around Tissedal.
With around 20 minutes drive from Odda or 30 minutes drive from Tissedal, you can reach this beautiful waterfall. The name is Lattefoss and I strongly recommend you to come here.
Lattefossen is an impressive twin waterfall located in the Odda Valley, very easy to reach from Tissedal. It has a height of 165 meters and is a well-known touristic attraction. I will now do a quick stop to Odda.
Behind me, Odda. If you want to climb Toltunga, you have two options to stay close to it. One is Tissendal and the other one is Odda.
Odda is a small village but bigger than Tissendal. I stopped to the supermarket. Norway is very expensive. I spent 70 euro for soy and almond milk, salmon, bread, peanuts, oats, nuts, yogurt, some snacks, tomatoes, one lemon, two bananas, cheese, other yogurt, and of course, berry cider. I love it.
Now I'm quite tired. I will cook something and then I will sleep enjoying this nice view. Good morning guys, the goal of today is to reach the top of Trolltunga, that means Trolltan, a mountain 1100 meter high. I am in my car, I have to reach the parking area. There are three parkings, P1, P2 and P3. P3 is the highest, it will save you a few hours to reach the top, it's the most expensive. In any case, the hike from the P3 is around 7-8 hours to go on top and come back.
The P3 is just at 15 minutes drive from Tissedal.
The parking places are limited in the parking P3, so you have to reserve your place in advance. I will put all the information in the video description. The hike begins. Guys, you need to wear good clothes, good shoes, good jacket. So come here prepared.
There is no entrance fee to Trolltunga. The nature here is absolutely amazing. It looks like I am in another planet. I suggest you to start the hike as early as possible because it requires 7-8 hours to reach the top and come back.
I never did this hike because it's very touristic, it's always fully packed. But today, due to the COVID-19 situation, I have to say that I am alone over here. The hiking path is well marked, there are sticks everywhere. So don't get worried, you will not get lost.
This part with stones can be challenging.
You need to do a little bit of squat in the gym before to come here. In this part, there are not any more the sticks to mark the path. You have to pay attention to the stones. Follow the red signs. The recommended time to do this hike is from middle of June until middle of September. Then it becomes challenging due to the weather condition. Don't forget to bring a bottle like this one. There is plenty of fresh water that you can drink. I have still 3 hours more or less to hike. Today is 26th of August.
Sometimes it's hot, but the weather changes often. It can get cold.
The best thing to do is to dress in layers. Finally, I reached the tan, and all people are standing for the classic picture.
Normally, you need to wait 1 hour in line to get the famous Trolltunga picture, but today there are just few people on top. Start the hike before 8 a.m. to be on top and come back with light and safely. I am in line for the famous picture. Don't step on the little stone on the side of the Trolltunga, it's dangerous. Trolltunga is a wide stone, you will not be scared. And finally I got my picture.
It's enough wide. In my opinion, this hike is not extreme. It requires just a moderate level of fitness. For me, it's time to get back home, so I have to do another 4 hours of hiking.
This hike was absolutely amazing. Guys, this episode is over. I hope that you enjoyed. See you soon. Bye.